Okay, guys, we're back at the swamp where we was at Friday night. We got ran out of here. We didn't get to catch that on video, but we thought we'd bring you back and do a daytime video where you guys could actually see a little bit better about this place that we're in. It's really something else going on. This little bridge here, that the road's been out of service for a long time. One side of the bridge.
It's probably where the bridge is down at the other end that we go across. It's real swampy.
Yeah.
The car goes.
Right.
Washes down in the rocks. It's probably right there. If you look down there, you can see. It's maybe where we cross over right there. Is that a bridge?
I don't know. I can't really tell, honey. But we're going to go back to the place where we were ran out of. Let you guys see what it looks like. So we're at the Slows Wildlife Management Area, Jenny Hole Unit. No cars or vehicles of any type, including four-wheelers or anything like that, are allowed back here. So we have a lot of area to explore that we didn't get to explore on the last video. So here we are again.
We tried doing a live for you guys down
here.
Yeah,
we just tried to do a live, and the signal's just terrible here. I don't know why. We get down here and let you see this spot where we got ran off from, and see all the broken limbs, and maybe even get into the woods a little bit. You can see it's a pretty swampy area. We're always on the lookout for footprints. I saw a bobcat the last time he was here. Now here's a we go over here to this side. See these big trees pushed down like that. All places where the deer bedded down, come through. If you can look. Trees have been broken here. I don't think deer would have done this. You see that right there? Another big tree right there. Two of them broken off at the same spot. There's another little patch right here. Like something's come out of there, coming this way, and just knocking these trees down in front of it. There's a big one right there. We're gonna try to get into these woods if we can. Trees knocked down.
Game, trail.
Yeah. Game trails running all through here.
There's a big one that
we've
seen the other night.
Yeah, that's the big.
I'm not sure if it is or not because it went straight across and I don't see over there, isn't it? There's a really nice green trail through here
too. We have some scat here. See two spots of it, one's fresh, one's not. Obviously coyote. And we got the game trail going all up through the woods. More limbs. Just knocked down by something. I don't know, guys. What do you think? Think deer's responsible for all this? Knocking down trees 4 or 5 inches around, like that one. If you do, drop us a note in the comments. Here's another one. You think a deer did that right there? Like no other trees around it falling onto it. And there's another one right there. So I think the woods opens up just a little bit up here ahead of us. And we try to get in there and take you guys in these woods.
Take that game so you think? They're not opened up enough yet.
Not opened up enough. Let's just go a little further, I think, up here by these big oak trees. It opens up a little bit. Look at just the sheer amount of trees pushed over. Look at that. It's just crazy. There are trees broken off 10 feet off the ground right here. There's three of them right in a row. 1, 2, and 3. I don't know if you guys can see that very good, but I've come across this before in Reed, Kentucky, twice in my life. Little trees broken off like that, 8 or 10 feet off the ground. If they weren't that close, they were about 20 or 30 feet apart, but crazy. Mainly wanted to see where this road leads to. I have a feeling it ends somewhere near the Jenny Hole. And show you guys what we were looking at the other night. And we decided to leave. Something started coming through these woods at us. See, look at that fresh break right there. Just trees down everywhere. Something started coming through these woods at us pretty quickly. So we decided it was best to retreat back to that little iron bridge. We hung out there for a little while, nothing happened. So let's keep going.
So I think that what we should do, baby, is since there's that big creek up here that we walked across the other night, we haven't got to yet. We need to wait until we cross that creek before we go out into the woods. Otherwise, we're going to walk. If you look right back here, see all that water?
Yeah.
We're going to have to cross that. So I would say let's cross the... Whoa. Take this. Look at the sign. What was that?
I don't know if you guys heard that. Latisha was talking. There's something come through the woods. Might have been a deer. Definitely something in there though.
Did you hear that?
Mm-hmm.
Crunch the leaves and get it to move again,
maybe? Let's try. probably a deer, but it moved for a second then stopped. As you can see, visibility is very limited in this thicket. Opens up here on our left side. That's the edge of the Jenny Hill.
Alright guys, sorry about that. Something really big came through when I was talking to Bart about getting across this creek before we go chomping out through those woods. They were coming up on the spot now where we had that loud crash. Yeah. There's a pretty red bird. Cardinal.
There's a road that goes in between the lake, I think.
Kind of looks like a old homestead.
Right.
May just be garbage.
I think maybe we should. Yeah, that's a squirrel.
Squirrel, yeah.
So even a squirrel running through these dead leaves sounds much bigger than it actually is. Let's walk down this trail.
If we can get across that creek.
So this is all new to us. We've never been here before.
We're trying not to make it chunky, guys.
Yeah.
It's hard.
And like Joe and Jesse Doyle, we have not yet learned to walk through these leaves like ninjas. But we're trying. We do want to be.
Hey, that was a white squirrel that just went across.
Yeah, let's be real quiet, as quiet as we can. We have the swamp over here to our left. Nothing but thickets and Latisha to my right. This is obviously an old roadbed. We used to be here before the bridge went out on Turkey Strait. Follow this down here a little ways and see where it goes. Right. I've taken so many Bigfoot reports from this area that I've lost count. So this is obviously the remains of an old road, maybe an old logging road or oil well road. We're gonna find out. Yeah, that's kind of strange. Like a little teepee structure here. man was definitely placed there. Didn't fall off any of these little trees, that's for sure. That's a big limb. Broken limbs. Broken vines.
Actually, we can
debunk
that right now.
You can? Can you debunk all these broken... the bottom of this one right here.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Where's the bottom of that one?
Possible. But then again, that piece right there looks more like it belongs to this piece right here. As far as age.
Yeah.
So
we don't come across many tree structures here in Western Kentucky. Very rarely do we even come across footprints. I think I've come across two sets of footprints that I thought were... might be Bigfoot in my whole life, so we're going to keep walking. Maybe we'll see something else that's interesting. Okay, we're back down here at the swamp now. Look at those cattails. We're 15 feet high. You see, look for footprints around these places, honey. See where the deer have been traveling in and out of there. All that matted down and laid down.
There's something right here. There's that swamp in through here.
At least we'll find out where this rope goes.
In the road.
I don't know, we'll find out though.
You see
him? Mm-hmm. So evidently this is some kind of turnaround, or used to be. Any little footprints to be seen other than deer and raccoons and the occasional bobcat. There's some fresher deer tracks right there. Something's been stepping all on this.
Is that a baby deer? That's weird.
You know, maybe rabbit. I don't know. They're not very big.
They're tiny. They're like an inch long.
I think they'd be likely to be rabbit prints.
Any type of bird could have landed there?
Not with a footprint like that, no. We're definitely at the end of the road here. Somebody has been coming back here, evidently. Partying. Mud flat here. to these deep ripples. But there's a trail right there.
Is that a game trail?
Yes. No footprints at all up here.
Mm-hmm.
That's unusual. All right, honey, let's go down this game trail for a little while. You want to? We've never been down. Thank you guys for coming exploring with us today. We're traveling beyond this point. That's us. Now I'm seeing some tracks.
Into the
wetlands, baby. Yeah, I think you might be right. They're almost pushed over trees. Tracks, but I can't feel what they are. They've been very substantial. Tells me something's been through here lately. Those briars. I don't know, I'm recording, I can't see. More briars right here.
How many?
I don't know, honey, I can't see, I'm recording.
Okay.
It doesn't take a genius to see that something's come through here. You guys see anything in this thick stuff that we don't see, be sure and leave a comment. Briars everywhere now. Don't let the taste of the stuff by these come through here, honey. You can see another tree right there, just broken off. These trees are broken off everywhere like this. And I do not think that a deer did that. That's a little much for a deer, right? Thank you, darling.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Get it back here.
Let's walk up to that little, that log. And take us a little break. Let me get a drink of water. This looks like a good seat right here. Sure there's no timber rattlers underneath there. It's like 65 degrees today. Alright. Take a little rest out here and be quiet for a minute and just see what we can do. see that. Got a nice, nice arch right here. You know me. If I see one of these, I just have to walk through it. Street dead and fell down. There you go. Everything still looks the same. So, you do not actually enter another dimension when you walk under these tree arches. That's busted. I'm Latisha now. Because you just saw a coyote.
He's
gray. Gray coyote across the trip, and they can go up here and get him on camera.
You're
going this way?
Yep. All right, we're heading back to the car. We're gonna go and drive to the other side of the Jenny Ho. There's a mandatory airplane flying over every time we come out to film, of course, to ruin our shot. Maybe I'm covered in stick tights. It's all right.
I'll have to let you pick them all off me when we get a chance. And I can check you for ticks, okay? Here, you can check me for ticks too.
Well,
let's knock on this bridge real quick. Let me see that. Just to see what happens. Thing, but not sure we could hear in all this wind. Okay, as you guys can see, we're down by the actual lake right now. The weather's really warmed up, temperature's warmed up really nicely. Sure sounds like one.
Mm-hmm. I wonder if there isn't very deep right here, is it?
No. Take you guys for a little stroll through these woods, see if we can see anything. Maybe accidentally catch some wildlife. That would be great.
I'm tripping
my
brush.
Don't let the brush get you.
Oh my goodness, they even pull the brush. Ouch.
Right into the briar patch. That looks like, I don't know what kind of scat that is.
Wow. That was incredible.
Did you make it? Oh, yeah, that's a coming up on it, honey. That's one of them. Look at you guys right here. Let's see this beaver deer. Oh. Go ahead, baby, Brian.
Okay, let's go on it. Go ahead.
You guys never seen one of these before or not? Oh, big mud. Got it close. Beaver would come swimming up right now, would be nice. Tisha, she's got that camera and she's like a wild woman. Another day in the swamps of Kentucky. How did that happen?
Yeah, I mean, it's like split.
The tree died, and then it broke. Sure, I saw a beaver right inside that hole right there. Mud's deep right here. Pretty sure I saw a beaver in the first one when I came up. He just ducked in. He ducked down. What in the world was that noise?
I don't know.
Did you hear that? Sounded like it was coming from behind me.
Guys, if you see anything we don't, let us know, okay?
Look how thick this thicket is, guys. Ever wonder what it would be like to walk through something like this? Let's find out. Fence marker there. Actually not as thick as it looks in here. Definitely can't walk through this stuff quietly. See a lot of deer been coming through here. That, however, I don't think it's a deer. You guys can see that. That's 8 foot up right there. Another fence post right there. Say most of these trees here are about 20 or 30 years old. So, anyway, I better get back to Latisha.
Okay, guys. Whew. There he is coming out of the woods. I found him. Or he found me one. He must have been way in there. I never did see him.
Okay, guys. We've abandoned Geneva and the Jenny Hole and driven on down to Union County. It's a dike road. The most historic site in Union County is right here. Up here by these grain silos. That's what's known as the Slack Farm. In 1989, hundreds and hundreds of Indian burials were dug up by artifact hunters, looted, and the holes left in the ground, skeletons everywhere. It was a really big deal. Resulted in the passing laws which prohibit people from digging into Indian mounds anymore, which is a good thing. I never dug anything. I always just service mine. But no one's allowed near that place. Right behind it, see that big hill there? That's where the locals say gorillas live. They call it Gorilla Hill. And it goes all the way. You can see how far this place is. All the way back down Dykes Road, or Dyke Road on the left. So, down here by the river, and got a boater here. The river's way up. The rough spot there, the rapids area, that's where the dike is. And we're gonna take a little trip through these woods. I had 3 or 4 reports of Bigfoot being seen coming up out of these woods, crossing this road.
Hey, everybody. We're down here at the Slack Farm. Bart will tell you the history of this place. He's getting pictures of the actual farm itself. I'm gonna look down and look at the dike. Hang tight till I get down there, okay, guys? And we'll step in on mud and fall down into the river. There's the dike.
So as you can see, we got a nice, muddy, clear surface here to check out for footprints. And this should go just like this for a long way down the river there. Okay guys, we weren't able to find any footprints in the mud there in Uniontown at the dike, but we were able to do a live stream. So you guys go check out that live stream if you haven't already. I'm gonna leave you guys with some strange footprints that we found impressed into the concrete of the Uniontown boat ramp there at the dike. So you guys check that out. Thanks for watching. God bless all of you. We'll see you next time.
That is me stepping down into that footprint.